Rose Garden with top 20 teams, 13th ranked Kansas, 16th rated Oregon. Simeon, Collison, Miles, Heinrich, and Langford for the Jayhawks. Robert Johnson, Luke Jackson, along with Hellquist, Davis, and Luke Ridenour for the Oregon Ducks. Clark Kellogg, Kevin Harlan. This is the highest Oregon has ever been rated in the history of their basketball program.
And this sellout crowd here to support the high-octane Ducks here in the Rose Garden.
And here we go with Heinrich working on Ridenour. And Collison on top to Langford. Heinrich's been playing with a bad back and a strain would pick him out of a Wednesday game, missing in there. Johnson with the rebound.
At practice yesterday, Kevin, he looked really good. He was aggressive. He went through the whole workout. Conditioning will be a factor for him. He's not played a game in over a week.
Kansas had a tough trip over the Thanksgiving holiday to the preseason NIT in New York, losing to North Carolina in Florida. And Oregon comes in with a 4-0 record. Ridenour missing badly. Simeon the rebound. Here comes Aaron Miles from Portland, Oregon. And picked up by Simeon. And Miles first shot. Hellquist the rebound.
Both teams really anxious and excited. You can see it in the early going here. Quick shots, four shots. At some point, they'll idle down here in the next minute or two. You need that first lather of sweat to build up before you relax and settle in.
Hellquist turns it over down low. Kansas comes in having lost two of their last three. Oregon, for the third consecutive season, four straight wins. A look at 15th-year head coach Roy Williams of the Kansas Jayhawks. And that's the start to our game, 0-2 and 0-3. Here comes Kansas with Mild. Into Collison, who can't get it to go. Johnson, another rebound. Ridenour, Davis, and Oregon sets up. Fast tempo offenses both ways as Jackson takes it inside and finds two.
That's one of the things Kansas has to defend against, Kevin, the ability of Luke Jackson to curl off of the down screen. And his size and with his strength, when he gets into the lane, he has a nice knack for being able to initiate contact and still finish the shot.
So 90% free throw shooter Luke Jackson at the free throw line from Creswell, Oregon. A junior at 6'7". And a guy whose game continues to develop from year to year to year.
Well, he and Luke Ridenour both have terrific work ethics, not to mention good skill packages. And when you combine the two, you get outstanding players.
And Collison finds a short hook inside to put Kansas on the board. Johnson inside with the great feed from on top.
If you get open and you have your hands ready, Ridenour will find you in scoring position.
He's as good a point guard as you're going to find in the country.
Without question, Kevin. One of the top two in my mind are out here on the floor. Both the top two in my mind. You might throw Jason Gardner in there as well from Arizona.
Heinrich trying to work on Ridenour. Shot clock is approaching 10. Here comes the sophomore Miles, who started virtually every game last year as a freshman. Working on Jackson, has the mismatch. Simeon inside was open.
Excellent find by Aaron Miles. He averaged 7 assists a game last year. Did a nice job displaying patience and allowing Simeon to get loose inside.
Ridenour takes it in, and a quick foul is assessed on the Jayhawks, and it goes on Miles for the first time.
Take a look at Collison here, demanding attention from two players. Crosswhite loses sight of the ball and his man while he's locked into Collison, and it's an easy basket for Simeon.
Johnson to Jackson. And over Collison. Crosswhite tried to get a hand on it, and out of bounds it goes. As Oregon, from the four, has started 2 of 5, and Kansas has started 2 of 6. It's hard to call an early December game a big game, Clark, but for Kansas, where they sit now and what they've got ahead and what was expected of them, it is a big game.
It really is, as Langford gets all the way to the rim for the throwdown. But you're right, Kevin, as a turnover is committed by Crosswhite. This is a statement game, and I think it's so for both teams. Kansas, their confidence a bit shaken as we see Keith Langford bouncing to the rack. But Kansas, because of what happened in the preseason NIT in New York, losing to North Carolina and Florida, the way they lost, lethargic, not energetic against North Carolina, the same way in the first half against Florida, they want to reestablish that they're a team that's going to be one to be reckoned with before this season is over.
An offensive foul on Kansas. Inside Langford trying to pry his way free, and a foul called at him after the first. Here are the two Lukes and the guys that basically comprise the heart and soul of this Duck team.
37 points a game to 7 rebounds per game. The Jacksons lead the team, and that's an area of concern for Ernie King and his coaching staff. How will they handle Kansas on the backboard?
And there's a three for Luke Jackson. Oregon losing last year in Madison, Wisconsin to the Jayhawks. A foul quickly called on the Ducks, and it goes on Robert Johnson. But is there a revenge factor for Coach Ernie Kent now in his sixth year with Oregon over the Jayhawks today?
I don't know if the coach will talk about a revenge factor, but I know the players are thinking revenge factor.
And a turnover, Ridenhour, cross white, and in for two. And Oregon has their biggest lead. Ridenhour was working on Heinrich. He knocked it away in the shot clock at 22 seconds. Heinrich will be watching the play of him because of that back injury. He's only taken one shot to start the game.
Seems to be moving rather freely. Again, conditioning, game conditioning is what will maybe stymie Heinrich here today.
Miles. And Johnson and Collison fight for it. Collison is inside picking up a foul. That's the first on him.
Speaking with Oregon assistant coach Scott Duncan, he talked about how the emphasis the last week and a half has been on boxing out, making sure that the Kansas Jayhawks don't get a chance to get second shots.
Ridenhour to Johnson inside. And Simeon kind of handcuffed him as he was going up. But a foul called on Ryan Simeon. That's the second one on him.
Jayhawks don't have much depth, Kevin. And to lose Simeon to foul trouble early is going to put some pressure on one of those unproven reserves to contribute early.
Like freshman Moulay Nyon, who is set to come in for the Jayhawks with Robert Johnson at the free throw line, an 80% free throw shooter. The senior from San Francisco hits his first. Here comes Nyon, who will take the place of Wayne Simeon. And, you know, we're talking about big players on the front line for Kansas, Clark. All this is because you talk about some of the pressure on them, the lack of depth. No Drew Gooden, who elected to leave a year early and head north.
You can't blame him for that. I think he's probably going to be the rookie of the year in the NBA.
So Oregon has a 7-0 run on the Jayhawks, and they've got their biggest lead of 6.
Powerful new Silverado is here. Still available with a 340 horse Vortec V8.
Santa, did you eat all the planters' nuts?
Reindeer.
There are nuts, and then there are planters' nuts. The fresh roasted taste of planters. This holiday, bring out the good stuff.
I am the Black & Decker cordless multi-tool. I can do just about anything. I can saw, I can sand, I can even drill. I'm a one-man construction crew. I am the multi-tool.
Now with Circ Saw and router attachments, available in kits of 3 or 5.
You look. You stare. You hold your breath. Your pulse races. Is it the clarity? Is it the performance? Is it the sleek design? Flat panel high definition television by Samsung. It's digital temptation, and everyone's invited.
needed a miracle to win and got it. Now Arkansas meets Moussa Smith and Georgia, the SEC championship, next on CBS.
Largest college basketball crowd in state history crammed in here to the Rose Garden in Portland, Oregon, with Clark Kellogg, Kevin Harlan. Great to have you with us, and some thoughts early on in the start.
Well, early on, Kansas, when they've shown patience and handled the ball, they've been able to get it inside. The explosiveness of the Oregon Ducks offense, though, the three-point weapon they use, has given them this six-point cushion.
You mentioned something before about the Kansas depth. 88% of their scoring, Clark, through the first five games they've played this year, have come from the starters. That, to me, seems like a very high number.
It really is a high number, but the bench players haven't established their role. They're not looked to score, but you've got to get something from them in the point column. And right now, Roy Williams trying to determine who can step in a high-pressure situation and make a contribution off the bench.
Oregon has not made a substitution. Yawn has come in for Kansas because Simeon's got two fouls. Here's Heinrich, who again has only taken one shot. Ridenour is on him. Keith Langford basically came off the bench last year, then starred in the tournament. Collison hanging in the air and shoved while in flight is going to go to the free throw line as he was fouled inside by the Ducks, and it goes on Crosswhite, who picks up his first.
Nick Collison, one of the premier big forwards in college basketball. Excellent footwork and good hands allow him to really cause problems down low.
Nice defensive player, too. Led the Big 12 in block shots a season ago.
You take a look at the book on Collison. Post moves are plenty. Good, soft suction cup hands. His weakness has been his tendency to pick up early, silly fouls. So far today, though, in the first 4.5 minutes, he stayed clear of foul trouble, and he'll get an extra free throw here as Oregon committed a lane violation.
77% shooter is Nick Collison. He leads the team in scoring it. A little over 20 points a game. And the Hawks back on defense. Oregon by five.
One of the keys for Kansas is to try to keep Oregon out of transition. You do that with good offense, scoring the ball, and not turning it over.
Luke Jackson inside. Collison with that rebound. And here comes Aaron Miles, who is a schoolboy hero here in the city of Portland. Collison with the travel and a Kansas turnover. And that's the third on the Jayhawks to start the game in the first 5 minutes of the game.
That's been a problem for Kansas. They've averaged 17 turnovers a game in their first five, Kevin. And the vast majority of those turnovers have been committed by their front line guys. It's Collison and Simeon, when he's out there, have to do a better job of taking care of the ball.
Johnson against Yawn. And Ridenour working on Myers. Robert Johnson, nice move inside, but maybe one step too many and called for the travel. So a turnover on the Ducks. That's their third turnover to start the game. Oregon lost a pretty key player themselves as they are the defending Pac-10 champions. Freddie Jones going to the NBA.
The Indiana Pacers had a terrific senior year. They miss his ability to make plays at both ends. He had the kind of athleticism and confidence to make a play when you needed it, Kevin. A big shot, a big drive, a defensive rebound.
Four Kansas turnovers. Oregon's biggest lead has been six. Kansas has not led. Nice move by Luke Brown. Oh, a seductive fake that gives the Ducks their biggest lead. Heinrich. And Collison trying to work inside on Crosswhite, slapped away by Ridenour. What's your feel on the defense on both sides of the floor?
Oregon doing a really nice job here, Kevin, in their man-to-man defense, making it tough for Kansas to get good looks. That time, James Davis going to be guilty of the foul on Heinrich.
Davis picks up his first.
Let's take a look at Luke Ridenour showing the ball to Aaron Miles, allowing him to fly by and then knocking down the open jump shot. This kid just loves to play.
Preseason All-America like his counterpart, Kirk Heinrich. With the free throw line is now 7 of 11 this season. We bring in Andre Joseph. He'll take the place of James Davis. So the first Oregon substitution is in the books. Heinrich again.
They like having Andre Joseph on the floor because he gives them a little more size on the perimeter, Kevin. Allows them to match up better with big shooting guards. Ian Crosswhite out of the action right now as he tries to tie his shoe.
Collison fell on him going up for that shot on the free throw and landed on his foot, and the shoe slipped off, and Crosswhite to the other end. His dad was an Olympian. His mom was a track star. More on that later on. He's from Australia. Get it at the other end. How about that? Loses the shoe, and if the slipper fits, it's 17-8. Sixth-ranked Oregon on top of the Jayhawks, under 13 to play in the first half. And now they've got the crowd in the game.
They sure do. Kansas can ill afford to come up with empty trips the rest of the way down.
Crosswhite just picked up a foul, much to the chagrin of his coach, Ernie Kent.
Nice little pick and pop action here. You see Crosswhite set the screen, then faded instead of rolling to the goal. There it is again, another look at it. Rittenour pitches it behind him, and Crosswhite, who's an excellent perimeter shooter, knocks down the three.
Crosswhite checks out, Hellquist will come in. And Wayne Simeon comes back in for the Jayhawks, playing with two fouls. Again, that lack of depth, they gotta bring in a guy with two quick fouls and a turnover by Kansas.
Kansas, a team who's had their confidence shaken with the two losses in New York, off to a bumpy start here. Look for Oregon now to really try to take advantage of this bumpy start for the Jayhawks.
Kansas has never led. Here's Robert Johnson working on Collison, the screen for Rittenour, who got by Miles, and Johnson trying to get the loose ball, falling, and a quick foul called on Kansas inside, and it's on Collison, and he picks up his second foul, so two frontline players for Kansas. They have two fouls apiece. Collison right there, and Wayne Simeon, who's already gone on the bench. And now is back out on the floor. And a turnover right there. And that's on Hellquist, who just checks in the game with a pick, and that's his first foul.
Well, Oregon has five big guys they'll rotate in and out of the action. Crosswhite, Matt York, Jay Anderson will get some minutes, Hellquist, and then Robert Johnson. Kansas doesn't have that same luxury.
They don't have the size Oregon has. Langford inside. Oregon is plus two in rebounding so far in the game as they fight for it. Out of bounds, the Jayhawks will inbound.
Hellquist lucky he didn't pick up a foul there as he took the legs out from under Keith Langford. Good hustle though both ways.
Kansas is 3 of 10 from the field. Oregon 54% to start. Collison with two fouls on Hellquist.
A bit of a gamble here for Roy Williams, but he doesn't have much choice. He has to keep Collison on the floor and trust that his senior can play without picking up a third foul.
If Jackson can't get it to go, and Collison is there to get it. He throws the outlet pass away. Miles couldn't snare it. And the Jayhawks turn it over again. They've got six turnovers. And the Jayhawks are down by seven. Collison with a nice move right there.
I'm a pony. A dollhouse, a 7/4 inch, 13 amp circular saw with case.
The Home Depot has the gifts people really want, like this Ryobi 12-volt cordless drill with hand vac, or this Dremel Multi-Pro Kit, your choice, just $59.97. Or give them a Home Depot or Expo gift card. They're convenient, guaranteed to fit, and available in any amount. Home Depot, your holiday workshop.
Powerful new Silverado is here. still available with a 340 horse Vortec V8.
Hey, pick me. I'm smiling.
Pick me, please.
You pick the dog over your brother?
No, not the dog.
The HP All-in-One Printer with Proof Sheet makes it easy to pick and print just the right shots.
Oh, that hurts.
The Navigator Handsaw from Black & Decker.
This one's been in my family for generations. This was made by Marie Antoinette. Ah, my favorite. It's from England.
Terry's premium chocolate balls make a whacking good holiday gift. Try new peppermint and pure milk chocolate.
She's engaged to Ben, but Monday she's all Dave's.
Should I touch that?
Yes.
Don't miss superstar Jennifer Lopez, plus survivor castaway Jake, Monday on an all-new Late Show.
It's been a tough go for Roy Williams and the Jayhawks. Losses in the preseason NIT to North Carolina and the Florida Gators.
We didn't guard the dribble very well, so teams were able to penetrate, particularly Florida would penetrate, pitch to the three-point shooter, and they make 9 out of 18 in the second half. We didn't dominate the backboards and get to the glass ourselves like we like to do. We didn't make open shots. We didn't run the ball. There were just so many different things. It was a total breakdown of our game for two games there.
That's an awful lot to try to get corrected between New York and now. And you take a look at what's going on in the wins and losses for Kansas. The two losses, you see the shooting percentage, everything Roy Williams talked about. So far today, even though it's been a sketchy start, they are within 7, but they've got foul trouble difficulty. Both of the guys you see there, Nick Collison on your left and Wayne Simeon on your right, have 2 personal fouls, and we've still got 11:44 to go in this first half.
Kansas has 6 turnovers in the last 5 minutes. Collison's got 5 points, but as Special K was just telling you, a couple fouls to deal with. Luke Jackson has 6 points to lead the Oregon Ducks. A little zone by Kansas.
Well, maybe a way to try to protect both Simeon and Collison. It frees up lanes to the offensive glass if the shot is taken and missed. So you've really got to attack the orange, and also gives Oregon something different to look at.
No changes either way after that timeout. Approaching 11 minutes to play in the first half. From outside, nails a three-point shot, giving the Ducks their biggest lead today.
Beautiful use of the skip pass from one side to the other over the zone, and a little brush screen freed up Rittenour for the jump shot.
Oh, and a sweet shot answered at the other end by Heinrich.
That was a quick rebuttal and much needed.
Andre Joseph, Elquist inside on Simeon. Quick double by Heinrich, didn't pay off, and he got the 2 nonetheless. Inside for Simeon, who's battled nagging injuries in his short time at Kansas.
Playing on a sore ankle now, but did a nice job there just catching and finishing.
Three, Luke Jackson puts the Ducks up by 10. Jackson in the contest has got 9 and 2 three-point shots, with Simeon coming at the other end with the deuce.
You can't just run back defensively against Oregon. You have to tag people and get to shooters, because they're coming at you full speed.
Rittenour collects the loose ball, and Jackson at the other side of the floor. Heinrich was there defending, and Heinrich's defense paid off. And the Ducks cough it up. Oregon is shooting 56%. Kansas has gone 27 consecutive games without allowing an opponent to shoot over 50% in the game.
Well, on the season, allowing the opposition 41%, but here in the early going, Kevin, Oregon able to get high quality shots, and shooting percentage always a function of the kinds of shots you get. You get good shots for good shooters, you're going to shoot a pretty high percentage.
And there's the other kid from Portland, Oregon, sophomore Michael Lee. He and Miles were teammates on a state championship high school team here at Jefferson High. in Portland. He does not see the kind of minutes Miles does as Heinrich looks down low for Collison and Oregon foul. Anderson in for the first time. Jay Anderson, who is from Fairbrook, Minnesota. Anderson picks up his first personal. Ernie Kent controlling the sidelines. He played at Oregon back in the early 70s, and quick inbound pass and Heinrich for two.
They took advantage of a sleeping defense there. The Jayhawks right back in it after Oregon had pushed that lead out to 10.
Heinrich's got six, a rebound by Michael Lee. And then he goes up to Miles at the other end, picked up now by James Davis. Simeon, right underneath, and knows he has got to buy.
You can see that Kansas, when they're patient, they can take advantage of Oregon inside.
Well, at the conclusion of today's game, we'll select the Chevrolet MVP of the game from each team. Chevrolet will make a contribution to each school's general scholarship fund, a tradition for 30 years. Chevrolet and CBS with Clark Kellogg, Kevin Harlan at the Phil Rose Garden, downtown Portland, Oregon. Kansas from the Big 12, Oregon from the Pac-10. Heinrich with a corkscrew shot. And here comes Andre Joseph. And Davis picked up by Lee and burns him with the great feet inside to Joseph. And a foul called on the Ducks. Shoving inside. And it goes on Davis for a second time.
James Davis is really a perimeter shooter. He's made 18 field goals. 16 of them have been from behind the arc.
Wow.
39 of his 44 attempts are three-point attempts. So I think he stepped out of character a little bit trying to take it to the rim there.
He had seven the other night against Grambling. Mm-hmm. So far, Oregon has knocked down 4 3-point shots. Kansas one.
Well, Kansas has an advantage by going inside to Collison and Wayne Simeon when they don't turn the ball over.
And turnovers have killed him to start the game. Seven so far with 8.5 to play in the first half. They bring Robert Johnson back in. He's out there with Jackson, Hellquist, Joseph, and Ridenour. Anderson will check out. Kansas with Heinrich and Collison, Simeon, Michael Lee, and Aaron Miles. Play by Johnson. And patient inside, which was key.
Exactly. You don't need to be in a hurry inside. You need to be quick, but on balance.
Free throws have been about the same to begin this game. And Collison outside, but you like him inside better.
Much more. He can make that shot, but he's more effective when he can get the defender behind him and get into the jump hook. And that might be the third on Collison.
It is number three on Collison with little depth on the bench, and Roy Williams has got some things weighing on his mind. As good as Collison is, you're gonna have to go to the bench and bring in Yawn once again from Senegal, West Africa.
Penetration by Jackson, and Collison just unable to get squared up to Luke Jackson on the penetration. He slid all his. Boy, from that angle, it even looked like he may have had a little more of an argument for that call going the other way.
Langford will come in for Michael Lee. The thing Roy Williams does with all of his Kansas recruits, he promises the kid, if they come to Kansas, a game with his Jayhawks in that kid's hometown. So we've got Lee and Miles, hometown Portland kids, trying to come to hometown tonight. Luke Jackson, the former high school player of the year in the state of Oregon. And he puts it in. Jackson has got 11 points and a couple of threes. And sixth grade Oregon on top of the Hawks by 10.
My new baby's name is Max. He's waking up about now. My business partner's name is Joe.
This has everything you're looking for. It has.
I see him more than I see Max. It's also my birthday. I wouldn't mind working from home today.
I'ma be alright. I'll keep on dancing. I'ma get the champagne.
The Gateway 1450 SE Notebook PC features an Intel Celeron processor.
Stood
the bowling.
Okay, see how the side of the rails warm more than the other side?
Felt like a million. Felt like number one. Like a rock.
What are you handing down to your kids?
Like a rock.
Chevy, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Hey, hand me that there,
Wrench?
Yeah.
Oh!
What do you think? I got that insurance or something?
What?
It puts money in your wallet in case you're, like, flat on your back.
What? Never heard of it.
Well, you can get it at work.
Get what?
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Do you have rollover minutes? Well, if you don't have Singular Wireless, you don't have rollover. Only Singular lets you rollover your unused anytime minutes from month to month. So get rollover, Singular rollover, and start rolling over minutes over and over and over from month to month to month. Do your minutes, keep them. Right now, get 1,000 anytime minutes that can roll over. And this cool Motorola phone, only from Singular. Hurry in, offer ends December 31st.
Interesting numbers. The points off turnovers standing out as Oregon has outscored Kansas there by 8 with Clark Kellogg, Kevin Harlan. Kansas now with the dilemma. They've got one of their best players off with 3 fouls on the bench.
Nick Collison, who was having his way inside when Kansas didn't turn the basketball over, will probably sit the rest of this half. Where does Kansas get their scoring from? They need Simeon to step up, and also Keith Langford, who's a capable scorer, has to start doing some work as well.
And they just brought in Jeff Graves. Somehow Kansas has got to keep up with the muscle of the Oregon Ducks. But again, you like when Kansas was operating inside, Collison close to the rim. And that's where some of their success early in the game was coming from.
He and Wayne Simeon able to work a good, effective high-low game. But now with Collison in foul trouble, Jeff Graves, a junior college transfer who has some skill, has good hands, can really pass, just hasn't shown the consistency and effort that he needs to show. But he'll have a big opportunity here now. Langford with a poor pass into the post.
Ridenour with Joseph at the other end. And Luke Ridenour gets the steal, sets up Joseph. And the biggest lead now for the Ducks is 31-19. Heinrich looking in for Johnson, who steals the ball. And at the other end, it's Miles coming back the other way for Kansas.
Real danger zone here for Kansas. They haven't had a good offensive possession the last 3 trips.
Miles down the lane, trying to scoop it home and gets his own miss. Langford will slither and fire. And Simeon is there to clean it up.
Penetration creates opportunities on the glass. Miles got inside and then Langford.
There's Jackson again. He is at a 13-point first half. And it's 33-21 Oregon, equaling their biggest lead. Heinrich on the perimeter. 6.5 to play, and a whistle on a Kansas turnover inside.
I think it's on Simeon, Kevin.
You're right, he's got 3, and Collison is on the bench with 3. Here's Simeon moments ago.
And then Langford just loses sight of the ball. No pressure on the passer, but Langford had his back turned. And when he realized what was happening, it was way too late. And Simeon just picked up his 3rd foul.
So he's on the bench with 3. Collison's got 3. Nyon comes back in the game and Graves, and that's the Kansas front line. We got Langford, Miles, and Heinrich in the backcourt. Jackson into Robert Johnson, into Graves. Up it away and a travel. A turnover. And that is the 8th turnover in the first half by Oregon. Tip off the holiday season with great gift ideas. And licensed NCAA fan gear. Just click on shop at CBSSportsLine.com. Or on AOL and our keyword, CBS Sportsline. 13th-ranked Kansas, number 6, Oregon. Oregon has never been rated higher. They try to go inside as Graves was looking for Miles, and out of bounds it goes. Shot clock at 22. Hellquist will check back in the game for Robert Johnson, a deeper Oregon bench by far.
Without question, Kevin, and they're going to try to exploit that advantage. They've already gotten Simeon and Collison in foul trouble, both out of the game with three. Now they're going against second-line players for Kansas, although Heinrich is as first line as you can get.
Second time, Heinrich has sneaked inside. An incredible display of three-point shooting as they've gone 5 of 6 in the first half. And Oregon has been absolutely sensational from above the arc this afternoon.
They average 26 attempts from behind the three-point line per game. They make 9 on average. And they shoot it freely and with confidence as you look at Rittenhour. That was after a made field goal by Kansas, showing you the kind of freedom and confidence he has in his three-point shot.
Hellquist just picked up a foul. He's got 2, and that is as much as any Duck has. We're back to the bench. Here comes 7-foot freshman Matt Short in the game as Michael Lee comes in for the Jayhawks. Hellquist will take a seat on the Ernie Kent bench. Tyler York is in the game. Yawn will come out. Langford back in. So Kansas going small, basically, with 4 guards and Graves in the middle. Kind of a 4 on the floor offense.
Right. Necessity is the mother of invention. Yeah. And with Simeon and Collison out.
Rittenhour again with another 3.
That high pick and roll frees him up.
6 three-point first half hits by the Oregon Ducks, who are shooting 60% from the field. Heinrich against Rittenhour. It's been a battle all afternoon. A foul called on Luke Rittenhour.
Well, Kirk Heinrich pretty much going to have to try to keep his team in it alone. Trying to take it off the dribble, draws the foul there on Rittenhour. The Oregon fans want that foul called on Heinrich. Thought he lowered the shoulder.
Heinrich, who had the great benefit while growing up in Sioux City, Iowa, being coached by his dad, Jim, from third grade on. That's a great luxury.
That gives you a lot of savvy and know-how. You take a look, he's just a guard, can play either guard spot effectively. Pound cake, simple. Stole that line from Coach John Chaney from Temple. But he's effective, and he's simple in how effective he is, but it's as good as something sweet as pound cake.
Guns are shooting 45%. We told you before, Oregon shooting 60%. Rittenhour sneaking inside, and York couldn't get it. Graves does, and the Jayhawks the other way, led by Miles. Set a Kansas assist record for freshmen last year. Heinrich outside, the defense slow. Lee cleans the glass, and an Oregon foul as they're going for the rebound. It goes on Luke Jackson, and he picks up his first foul. Kansas again, a couple players and foul problems for them. Collison with 3. And Simeon with 3. Oregon has led by as many as 14 points, up now by 12. And junior college transfer Jeff Graves at the free throw line.
Here's a guy that I think has the ability to help Kansas. He's a junior college transfer, and a lot of times, Kevin, the adjustment from junior college to the intensity level of Division I basketball creates a gap for JC transfers. And if he works through that, he's already lost about 20 pounds after a car accident kept him inactive for a while. He has good skills. He's got good hands. He's strong. It's just a matter now of consistently showing the kind of effort and practice that will earn him consistent minutes on the court during games.
275 is what he weighs. You say he's lost some weight.
Yeah, he went down a little bit.
Lee tried to snap it away from Johnson. Rittenhour at the other end. Caught by Davis, inside, rejected by Langford, and picked up by Heinrich. And he'll streak the other way, finding Miles, who takes it down the baseline, and he traveled. That's 11 Kansas turnovers.
Excellent help defense here, as the Jayhawks guilty of running back without seeing the ball. Langford caught sight of it just in time to deny that shot by Davis.
Anderson back in the game for the Ducks. Davis to Anderson, Rittenhour out there. Jackson remains on the floor. Robert Johnson patrolling the block. He's working on Graves. And Jackson double-teamed Lee with the rebound. Miles again to the trailing Heinrich for 3. And he has struggled with that three-point shot this year. Miles for two. Between the eyes. Make it a three. And Kansas has cut the one-time 14-point Oregon lead down to eight. And Davis for three.
That's what he does. Off the penetration from Rittenhour.
His scoring has doubled from last year. His minutes have doubled from last year. And for him, most importantly, his attempts have doubled from last year.
Well, he's an excellent catch and shoot perimeter player. He's not very tall, so he's not going to make plays in traffic. But when he has an opportunity to catch and shoot with the shoulder square, mark it up and go back.
The foul went on Johnson. That's his second. And they've got Langford at the line, Kansas does. One of the great things you notice sometimes sitting courtside is the respect these players have for both their coaches. Every time one of the Oregon players comes over to Ernie Kent, incredible eye contact. And the same is true with Roy Williams on the Kansas side. The respect these two coaches have just among the guys they coach is fabulous.
That's an excellent observation. And it's due to the way both handle their players and their teams, the way they communicate, and what they demand from their players. One of those little attention to detail kind of things that you consistently see in the programs that excel and with the coaches that excel. And you've got two outstanding coaches in this game today.
Michael Lee picks up the foul. Boy, he came
keep battling,
barreling
Mike,
over here in front of us. He was a high school tight end, and he actually had more football scholarship offers than he did basketball scholarship offers.
As a guy who does a bunch of football, I figured you would make note of that.
And they've got at the other end of the floor Andre Joseph, who is a junior from Houston, Texas, who himself a junior college transfer. He began his college career at Stephen F. Austin. And a rebound by Lee, who's given him some nice minutes with some rebounding.
Well, coming back home, getting an opportunity to play. He's physical, he's aggressive, and he's much needed with Simeon and Collison in foul trouble.
And he takes a three. Oh, and he nails it from outside. An unlikely source with a three-point shot, his first of the season. On his first attempt, his first hit.
Were his ears burning? He was right here in front of us. Right on cue.
7-point game. Swirling inside the lane, Rittenhour with the rebound by Graves. The outlet to Lee, who's playing with confidence. Great pass to Heinrich. That was a beauty.
As pretty as it gets, Kevin, in transition.
At the other end, Andre Joseph bulldozing his way inside. Graves with the rebound. Miles picked up by Jackson, and he'll slide in for two. The pace is incredible. Timeout taken by the Jayhawks. It's a track meet inside the Rose Garden with two top 20 teams.
This is a message from America to the extraordinary men and women who are serving their nation during this holiday season. From the folks back home.
Aloha. Be safe and come home soon.
Even though you're far away from home, I hope you have a really happy holiday.
Our hearts are with you, folks. Keep up the good work and come home soon.
Happy holidays. Happy holidays.
You're doing a great and noble thing, and this right here is what you're fighting for.
America says thank you.
Kansas on a 12-3 run. Oregon is led by as many as 14. Tomorrow, the AFC race runs amok. Most of you will see in the first half of our doubleheader the Buffalo Bills with Drew Bledsoe against the New England Patriots. And then Oakland and San Diego. Randy Cross and Beasley Reese and I will be in San Diego tomorrow, all beginning with the NFL today at 12 noon Eastern, 9 Pacific, right here on CBS with Clark Kellogg, Kevin Hart. We're in the Rose Garden. Biggest crowd to see a college basketball game in the history of this state. Langford finds Miles for three and finds an air ball. As Graves continues in there, and Kansas Clark continuing with four guards. Because they got Collison and Simeon in foul trouble. We take a timeout.
There's a place that I travel when I want to roam, and nobody knows it but me. The roads don't go there, and the signs stay home, and nobody knows it but me. is far, far away and way, way afar. It's over the moon and the sea. And wherever you're going, that's wherever you are. And nobody knows it but me. Chevy Tahoe, like a rock.
Only Remington has the most cutting blades, the fastest cutting speed, and the most total floating head action. How important is that? Well, how important is a close, comfortable shave? Remington, what a great shave feels like.
I'm not exactly a small person. Never have been. There aren't many things made for someone like me. Not many things at all. The Black & Decker swivel drill is. It works in 5 different positions, so I don't have to.
It's pretty cool for a little guy.
The swivel drill from Black & Decker.
It's coming on Christmas. They're cutting down trees, putting up rain, dancing songs of joy and peace. Oh, wish I had a river I could skate. I wish I had her so long.
Fight the good fight, fellas. Come home soon.
I just want to say thank you from this proud American.
Wish I had a river.
You don't even know me, and you're risking your life for me. Thank you. Oh, oh.
Coming up on the singular at the half, join Jim Nance and Bill Raftery for all the scores and highlights. We'll have a report from the SEC football championship game featuring Arkansas against Georgia. It's coming up on the singular at the half. Well, 7 3-point hits for Oregon. Luke Jackson's got 15. Ridenhour's got 11. Kirk Heinrich leads Kansas with 12 points. Ridenhour's been terrific. 8 assists and 11 points to start the game.
He gets it done at that point guard position. His penetration sets up other folks. They run a little high pick and roll action for him, Kevin, to allow him to get into the lane or step behind the screen and shoot the lethal three-point shot.
And again, Simeon and Collison for Kansas on the bench. 3 fouls apiece. A short bench for the Jayhawks. And here comes Davis. Anderson. Luke Jackson for 3. And a rebound by Miles. Kansas plus 6 in rebounding this afternoon.
And they're minus 3 or 4 in 3-point field goals made. And that's the difference in the game at this point. Hand check by Davis. One of the things that's allowed the Jayhawks to stay this close is that the fact that Oregon got over the limit with fouls relatively early. And the Jayhawks have been knocking down free throws.
And some good adjusting by Roy Williams with the big guys and foul problems to go with what he's got, a lot of point guards, 2 guards, and he's using them.
Yeah, he's got all forwards and guards, no centers, and his 2 best big guys are on the bench with 3 fouls. There you see Collison and Wayne Simeon, both with 3 fouls. Kansas doing a nice job. Michael Lee and Jeff Graves in particular off the bench, giving the Jayhawks a nice lift. The question becomes, if they can stay tight the rest of this half, how long can Simeon and Collison go, and how effective can they be playing the next 20 minutes with the 3 fouls?
That's a good point. Langford, by the way, 3 of 4 from the free throw line this afternoon. He's only shooting 47% from the stripe, so they're getting it from the stripe. Is Kansas. Cross White back in the game. And Jackson, great fake on the crossover, and the jam! A sensational move by Luke Jackson.
Because he can shoot so well from the 3-point line, you have to crowd him. Langford tried to jump over the screen and created an open lane to the baseline, and Jeff Graves just didn't take a good enough angle to cut him off. Nice strong move by Jackson.
Kansas has had 1 lead. That was a point, 6-5, and Oregon has led most of the game. And their lead has been as high as 14 points. 18 now for Jackson. Langford. Look at the size difference with Oregon. It's Langford still stuck behind the lines and went inside.
And look at this transition after a made field goal, Kevin.
They try the alley-oop, and Jackson has a triple off his fingertips, and here comes Heinrich the other way. Anderson and Ridenour there. What a pass by Heinrich as Lee was stationed underneath, and a foul called on the Oregon Ducks. It goes on Joseph, who picks up his first, but Heinrich had some serious smoke on that pass.
He sure did. Nice job here recognizing that he had an open teammate underneath. The Ducks late recognizing and matching up, and Lee will get two foul shots. Because both teams play up and down, no lead is safe in this kind of a game.
Lee at the free throw line. Heinrich with a point guard type pass, and that's where he may play when he leaves college, but he played point guard the first 2 years he was at KU.
That's why I call him simply a guard, yeah. Because he can give you contribution, whether he's running your team or whether he's playing without the ball.
What a lecture to have as Bryant Nash checks in for the first time to take the place of Michael Lee, who has been very effective while in the game for Kansas. 5 points, and he had 4 rebounds, and he had to rebound because the big men of Kansas are on the bench in foul problems.
That's a very productive line for his time on the floor.
Ridenour flies inside, and a charge on Luke Ridenour. And that's his second foul. Only one player for Oregon in foul trouble right now, and that's Andre Davis. He has 3. How'd you find Roy Williams yesterday?
Roy was a little concerned about his club, worried about their confidence level. I think if I talk to him in the next 40 seconds, he'd be feeling pretty good, other than the fact that his 2 big guys are in foul trouble. But he's got contributions from his bench, which has been a real sore point throughout the first 5 games of this season. Just no consistency from his reserves, but forced into duty today. They've stepped up and stepped up nicely.
You don't feel real good considering those guys are in foul problems. 2 players he counts on a lot, and he's only down 47-43, and he was down by 14 earlier in the half.
Well, they've got to make sure they defend, especially the 3-point shot here. You don't want to give up a demoralizing 3 here to Oregon if you can.
Oregon has hit 7 threes in the first half. Crosslight will fake and too many steps in the travel.
Well, he passed up a shot. Trying to get that closer parking space in the parking lot at the mall. Take the first available one and then walk to the store.
Sounds like you've been doing some pre-holiday shopping.
Well, I've seen folks do that before.
Heinrich trying to beat the clock. And on the fly, rebound Jackson, and he'll hold it. An impressive first half for both teams in different ways. That's the end of the first half. Oregon 47-43. Jim Nance and Bill Raftery will be by with the singular at the half after these messages. Kellogg, Kevin Harlan, a 3-point shoot in this first half.
Between the two teams, 10 of 15, but Oregon made 7 of 9 from behind the 3-point line. That's really why they're on top, Kevin, even though the margin is only 4. Take a look early on. The Jayhawks late tagging Luke Jackson, and he makes some pay. Then Ridenour on the penetration to James Davis, another one from behind the line. But Kansas hung tight because they did a nice job at the free throw line and got good play from their bench.
Had to alter their lineup because of the foul problems with Collison and Simeon. What do you expect in the second half with Williams and manipulating that lineup to keep those guys fresh?
Well, he'd like to, he might show you a little more zone defensively to try to protect Collison and Simeon. But I think offensively they're going to try to play smash mouth basketball if they can't run it. And that's the high-low action between Collison and Simeon. Both teams turned it over quite a bit in that half. It was an entertaining first half. But Kansas had 12 turnovers, and Oregon had 11.
Oregon led by as many as 14 points, and Kansas outscored them 18-8 the last 5-plus minutes to cut it down to 4. Kansas had 1 lead at 6-5. That was it. OK, just talked about the turnovers. Drew Gridnauer has been sensational in his career here, and today living up to everything we've read about.
I've watched him for his whole career at Oregon. First time I've had a chance to see him live. And he's a terrific point guard, plays with a lot of poise and confidence, and the system that Ernie Kent employs for this team gives everybody great freedom to do what they can do.
Johnson knocked it away, shot clock plenty of time. Langford, Collison, Miles, Heinrich out there for the Kansas Jayhawks, and Simeon. Luke Jackson along with Luke Gridnauer, who pops a three. Robert Johnson out there. Jackson with the rebound and puts it in. Hellquist along with James Davis, the five to begin the second half for the Oregon Ducks, as Langford finds Miles to Simeon to Heinrich. And Heinrich now finds Jackson on him and not Gridnauer. And Collison over Johnson. And a rebound by Heinrich, who is not boxed out, and the tap-in is good.
And he stayed with it. He missed the initial offensive rebound. But again, that's the problem. Kansas out-rebounded Oregon in the first half. Because the statistics you want to look at when you try to gauge games, the three that you can always hang your hat on as we look at rebounding here by Heinrich is rebounding, turnovers, and the free throw game. Usually the team that controls those statistical areas is going to come out on top. The X factor is three-point shooting, which could negate any advantage you might have in one of those other categories.
You talked about rebounding. Oregon only has two offensive rebounds this afternoon. Kansas has six. A three, an NBA three at that, with the rebound by Collison. Heinrich, they've got numbers the other way. Miles with the hesitation and the drive and the Hellquist foul. And that kid is Fearless Miles, who is a high school all-state quarterback. Their team won the state championship his senior year.
Nice job here in transition. He paused his defender, got inside, then went strong to the rim to draw the foul on Hellquist. And the Jayhawks shot 12 of 16 from the line in that first half game, while Oregon was only 6 of 7, so a six-point advantage at the line for Kansas.
Ross White comes in for Hellquist. We've talked about the point guards in this game. The point guards out of the city of Portland, we talk about Miles, who's a sophomore from Kansas, Terrell Brandon, who played at Oregon, and, of course, Damon Stoudemire went on down to Arizona to play.
Not a bad pair there.
No, both those veterans from Portland and Miles as well. So they've got a history here, and Miles grew up admiring those two players. Luke Gridnauer, 51-46, number six Oregon, the highest ranking in the history of their basketball program. And Heinrich trying to go inside. Davis knocked it away. Here comes Gridnauer, three on one, and Gridnauer takes it himself and gets his own miss, and a rebound by Simeon.
Boy, he had an advantage, three on one, elected to take it himself. The spacing was a little too tight to get a layup for his teammate.
Travel on Langford, a Kansas turnover.
You take a look at Gridnauer, had he and, see, they were too tight. Three guys too tight, it allowed one defender really to bother Luke Ridnauer's shot. James Davis should have slowed up and allowed it to be a two-on-one with him trailing. They would have gotten a layup there.
And teams work on that three-on-whatever break all the time.
All the time. But it's a matter of recognition on the fly, and that time Davis just kind of clogged things up a bit.
Davis trying to shove it inside, gets it back after it was deflected and misses the shot. There's Robert Johnson working the glass again. Johnson's got six rebounds and 8 points, and he's given him some great minutes on that front line.
And he sacrifices his body to defend people in there, too.
That's about what Johnson is averaging. And Simeon with a twirling shot. Jackson with the rebound. Look at the speedy Gridnauer to Davis at the other end. Across the lane, into Miles. Trying to scoop it home, and Collison with the rebound. Crosswhite picks up a foul. That's the fourth on him. Next conference glory and big time bowl hopes are in the mix when Matt Jones sparks the Arkansas Razorbacks against David Green and the Georgia Bulldogs. It's coming your way next on this Southeast Conference Championship presented by Dr. Pepper. For more, go to CBSSportsLine.com. AOL CBS Sports Line. With Clark Kellogg, Kevin Harlan. Great screen by Collison. Heinrich's three won't drop. Ridenour with the rebound.
You're right, Kevin. That was excellent execution. Just didn't get the shot to fall.
Ridenour wins it again. And he's got 15 points. Heinrich the other way, shifting his way through defenders and meets Ridenour in the circle. Who's better with the fast pace, Kansas or Oregon, as Miles pops a three?
I think Oregon at this juncture in the season. Heinrich is not 100% healthy. Simeon is bothered by a sore ankle.
Simeon playing in foul problems. And Crosswhite trying to get it out to Ridenour, and a foul is called on Miles, who picks up his second personal foul. Simeon's got three, Collison's got three, and some substitutions for KU.
Going to get a pick right there, and then Ridenour comes right off of it with a little shot. Right there, boom. Robert Johnson just enough to bother Aaron Miles. And Ridenour only needs a nanosecond.
Yeah, maybe. Let's see, they've got Michael Lee in now for Miles. Jackson down the lane through traffic. Jeff Graves has come in the game. And Nyon. Mulai Nyon will check in for Kansas. Heinrich and Nyon. And tapped in by Jeff Graves.
Jeff Graves. You know, Roy Williams doing a smart thing here, recognizing the TV timeout is coming up on the next dead ball situation. Getting Simeon and Collison out of the game so they don't pick up a cheap foul, and they also get some additional rest.
And a foul inside on Kansas. And that goes on Yawn. Timeout taken. Oregon on top, 55-48.
Lexus December to Remember sales event.
It's beautiful.
That looks good.
Here's a nice one.
What is this?
Outside.
You'll find incredible values whether you buy or lease.
Go on.
The December to Remember sales event.
Hey, what you got there?
Missing it would definitely spoil the surprise.
Come on, let's go.
See your Lexus dealer.
She is great. She's a great lady. In fact, I just lent her my Black & Decker zip saw. She's become pretty attached to it. You know, you can cut these beautiful patterns in everything from wood to metal. I don't miss it.
The Zip Saw from Black & Decker.
Buy any Olympus digital camera, and you'll get the most realistic digital images yet. And for a limited time, a $75 rebate on select Epson Stylus photo printers. Go to olympus.com/promotions for details. Olympus. Nothing's impossible.
Your ultimate online sports experience. For the fastest scores, stats, and first-rate fantasy sports, go to CBSSportsLine.com or enter AOL keyword CBS Sportsline.
The University of Kansas truly is the cradle of coaches. Dr. James Naismith, the game's inventor, was the first basketball coach at KU, and Fog Allen, a player under Naismith, became a Jayhawk coach for 39 years, and Adolph Rupp played under Fog Allen and became a legend in the bluegrass state of Kentucky. And Dean Smith also crafted his skills under Allen. He became a coaching legend in North Carolina. And of course, Roy Williams was an assistant for 10 years at North Carolina, a couple of those unpaid under Dean Smith.
Mm-hmm. The Dean Smith coaching tree has a bunch of branches on it.
And a lot of success. Kansas is shooting 39%. Oregon shooting 44%. Oregon is led by as many as 14. That was back in the first half. Jayhawks have had 1 point leads early on at 6-5.
Heinrich has held up quite well, Kevin, considering this is his first game action in well over a week. He didn't really practice much this week. Went full go yesterday and seems to be doing quite well right now.
Lee picked up by Ridenour. And Langford for three. And a big shot by Keith Langford, who is a 37% three-point shooter. Langford with 10 and his first three-point hit right there. Cross White from Australia. And out of bounds. And we're trying to get it. And the Late Show with David Letterman coming up on Monday. Don't miss superstar Jennifer Lopez, plus a brand new top 10 and more. It's the Late Show with David Letterman on CBS, America's most watched network. Heinrich inside, through the defense, and down! Blown away by Kirk Heinrich. I guess that back is feeling pretty good.
Oh, I think he's feeling quite well. The concern was conditioning and not wanting to tweak it. The fear of possibly tweaking it again. A little high pick and roll action, much like Oregon runs for Luke Ridenour. Watch James Davis get brushed off. Right there, bang by Collison. And then Heinrich able to finish in traffic and convert the foul shot. And it's as tight as we've been in a while.
8-0 run by Kansas. 14.5 to play in regulation. They got Jackson on top and a cross-court pass to Luke Ridenour. Launching a three. Robert Johnson has been superb. Underneath, he has 10.
He really has been. He can hold his ground. He's strong enough in his lower body to fight bigger players and hold them off and get to that offensive glass.
And he's got 8 rebounds, too. Langford trying to make a move. There's some shoving away from the ball. Collison down low. Trying to get his space, and he picks up his 4th personal foul. And the concern grows for Coach Roy Williams.
Jay Anderson and Collison fighting and fighting. See, Collison got the arms going. You get open in the low post with your feet and your lower body. He got the swim stroke going, got that elbow up and out, and picked up the offensive foul.
Collison's got 5. He has not scored in the second half. Ridenour to Jackson. Anderson is coming the game. Robert Johnson down below and with the ball. Andre Joseph to Johnson. And a shove and a foul. It's inside. It's on Kansas. And Heinrich is there. And Heinrich picks up the foul. That's the first on him today. 14-01 to play in this second half. Jackson setting a screen for Joseph. Now Langford comes out on Jackson. Screen by Anderson, a good one it is, and Joseph free to fire. Graves with the rebound. Michael Lee trudging the other way. And hopping in the lane and can't get it to go. Graves and Johnson jump ball. Kansas will get it on the possession.
I think Oregon's going to get it. The fans here were frustrated that it wasn't a foul call, but from their reaction, well, maybe it is. Let's see, I don't know if anybody knows whose ball it is.
That's exactly right.
Or at least which way they're going.
And the clock now is showing a minute 33, which is obviously wrong. So we've got a clock issue to deal with. As the Jayhawks come in this game 3-2. And Oregon comes in at 4-0. Kansas has not beaten a ranked team their last two games, going back to the Final Four last year in the loss to Maryland as they rectify the clock. And, of course, the loss earlier in the preseason NIT to Florida.
We talked about it earlier as a statement game for Kansas trying to regroup. But it's also a huge statement game for Oregon. You mentioned how this is the highest they've been rated as a basketball program. Simeon just carving out weak side space and gobbling up that board.
Kansas again to within a point. And Anderson for two. He was right on the line. Heinrich gets a screen from Graves. And maneuvers for a free shot and a foul on Kansas. And it's inside on Michael Lee away from the ball. Instructions for Heinrich. Robert Johnson will take a breather. Hellquist comes back in.
Boy, Johnson is one of those guys that you really don't notice until you watch this team closely. Does a lot of the little detail things that help you win.
Kansas plus six in rebounding. Anderson again has hit two consecutive shots. He's only averaging 5 points a game, and it's 62-56. And we welcome those of you that have been watching the Michigan Wolverine Duke Blue Devil game with Clark Kellogg, Kevin Harlan. We're in the capacity-filled Rose Garden in downtown Portland. Kansas has trailed by as many as 14. They've led once by a point. Foul problems for their front line. Oregon has gotten sensational play from Luke Jackson with 20 and Luke Ridenour with 15. Oregon ranked number six in the country, the highest ranking in the history of their basketball program.
And right now trying to ramp it up defensively. Oh, good elevation by Langford.
Langford knocks it in with a congested lane all around him.
Well, when it's congested down below, go up over it. And that's exactly what he did.
Here's Ridenour working on Miles. And Jackson picking on Langford. Oregon is shooting 44%. Kansas shooting 42%. And Ridenour has 17 points. Kansas is being led by Heinrich's 19 points. And he's got the ball now. And away from the ball, a whistle and a foul. And it's on Hellquist, who is outside the circle, and he picks up his third person, make it fourth personal foul. Well, it's been cool hand Luke. It's just which one you want to choose.
If you're Kansas, just pick your poison. Here's Ridenour in transition. Doesn't go, but there's Luke Jackson to bail his teammate out. And off this high pick and roll, there's Luke Ridenour. Nothing but rope on the 15-foot jump shot.
Kansas comes in 3-2, Oregon 4-0. And here's Miles to Langford. Collison on the bench with four fouls. And they try to sneak inside. Out of bounds it goes. 23 seconds on the shot clock. 11:52 to play in the second half. And a timeout with two top 20 teams going head-to-head.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've got no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Discover the difference on The Early Show.
Whoa. Buy any movie, get a free rental. Ray, get out here. You gotta see this.
Would it have killed you to knock first?
You get more when you buy movies at Blockbuster, like free rentals. This holiday season, buy any new movie on DVD or video, even the biggest hits, and you'll get a free rental. Free rentals. Another reason the best way to buy is Blockbuster.
Hurry to the Bel Air Camera Superstore for their four-day no-tax super sale. Pay absolutely no sales tax on 35mm SLR cameras and lenses, digital cameras, video cameras, tripods, accessories, and so much more. Plus, we're giving away a total of $500 a day to the first 27 people in line. All you gotta do is show up.
That sounds crazy!
It is. We are. The Bel Air Camera four-day no-tax super sale. Factory reps on hand to demonstrate the latest in digital technology.
The lens cap.
So don't get caught napping. Hurry down to Bel Air Camera's four-day no-tax super sale. 10925 Kinross in Westwood Village.
There's this guy. Oh, it's in my face. Shouting at me. Just pushes me. But I love him. He's my coach. My coach.
Be a coach. Be a fan. Special Olympics.
new comedies from De Niro, Crystal and Cage, plus Oscar picks. Next, hot.
And the defending Pac-10 champion Oregon Ducks on top 64-58 because the two loops, for one reason.
Their two high-powered offensive players have produced terrifically here in the first 30 minutes. 37 points between them, 9 assists for Luke Ridenour. And on the flip side of that, Heinrich coming off of the back strain, did not play in Wednesday night's win against Central Missouri State. And Nick Collison in foul trouble has been unable to get going.
Neither team made a change during that break. 11:52 to play here in the second half. Langford will inbound. Simeon trying to get free. Heinrich finally does, but the defense of Ridenour is all over the place, including right there. Miles had it knocked away. Ridenour against Heinrich at the other end. Well, Kansas cut it to a point, 57-56. Oregon, since that time, has gone 4 of 4 from the field.
They're doing it with defense. Good activity at the defensive end, Kevin. Nothing easy for the Jayhawks.
We got Joseph on Heinrich. And he'll take it right into the teeth of that Oregon defense. And out of bounds, and 8 seconds to fight.
Heinrich slow to get up as you take a look at Ridenour. After they created the turnover, he's able to go up and under Kirk Heinrich.
Kirk Heinrich is hurt and will leave, and Michael Lee will take his place. Heinrich came in with a strained back, forcing him to miss a lot of practice this past week, including a game on Wednesday. But here looks like he's holding his leg.
Looks like a cramp. And that's part of the conditioning that you don't get when you're unable to practice.
And a deflected shot that Miles took. Miles is from Portland and coming back home today to play in a Jayhawk uniform. Here comes Ridenour with a screen by Anderson. Outside Jackson. And as he tries to maneuver inside, we got it for Robert Johnson. And Oregon is on 11-2-1 as Heinrich battles a cramp on the Kansas sideline.
This holiday season, Honda's got great deals on new sport and utility ATVs, so you can play in the snow or in the dirt. Qualified buyers can get $29 payments for the first 6 months with a Honda card. Or lock in our lowest rate of the year, a 4.9% fixed APR through Honda Financial Services. Plus, you can get up to $300 in bonus bucks when you purchase select models. But hurry, gifts that go are going fast.
My son Donovan and I are making sure everyone in Philly is eating good.
Oh, man, hey, what are you doing?
You need some nice, hot, chunky soup to fill you up right.
Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger. Big chunks of veggies and hearty sirloin burgers grilled to perfection.
How can I thank you guys?
Donovan!
Oh, Mom, one more?
Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger fills you up right.
Life is full of difficult choices, and some not so difficult. When you purchase an elegantly redesigned mid-size 2003 Saturn L Series, you can choose $2,500 toward your down payment. Or get 0% financing, zero down payment, and zero payments for 90 days. Unfortunately, this not-so-difficult choice ends January 2nd. Purchase a 2003 Saturn L Series and get $2,500 toward down payment. Or 0% APR, zero down payment, and zero monthly payment for 90 days. See participating retailer for restrictions.
And never let you down. Make it a Bud Light.
Oregon shooting 47%. Kansas with 5 more turnovers than the Ducks. Clark, 3 minutes ago, Kansas was within 1 point. Now they trail by a 10-point margin. What happened?
Defense picked up for Oregon. They turned a couple of turnovers in the basket. That energized their offense, and they executed and got some easy things inside. And that's how quickly they can strike. They're a team that is always in attack mode, and when they turn you over, they're going to score at the other end because they push the ball so rapidly, and Luke Ridnour typically makes good decisions with it.
Heinrich back in with Lee, Graves, Simeon, and Miles. That's for Kansas. Ridnour and Jackson in for Oregon with Joseph Anderson along with Robert Johnson, who has put in a very good game underneath for the Ducks.
He has been so solid at both ends.
Michael Lee from Portland. Simeon. Heinrich again, and Heinrich leads Kansas with 19 points. How about the Duck defense?
It's been excellent in spots throughout, and they change it up too, Kevin. Man-to-man, some zone.
That's a travel. Miles with the travel. Only two Survivor episodes left this Thursday. It's the Ultimate Reward Challenge. The winning could put one castaway at risk. Don't miss the countdown to the finale. Who will have a chance to be the ultimate survivor? Find out on an all-new Survivor. Thursday at 8, 7 Central on CBS, America's most watched network. Driving Ridnour inside, can't find it. But does get the rebound.
Well, that was just a poor pass by Graves. The outlet receiver has to create some space. Get away from that rebounder.
Anderson losing it. And Kansas digging it out. Here comes Miles. Lee barreling in from the side. And we'll count it for two and a foul called on Johnson. That was a big time play by the sophomore from Portland, Oregon, Michael Lee.
When you've got a tight end's body and you've got quickness and ball handling skills, you can go into the paint, take contact, and still finish the shot.
Keith Langford out of Texas will check in for Kansas, taking the place of Graves, and Kansas downsizing. We saw it in the first half to deal with some foul issues, and they're doing it again here in the second half.
Well, it was an effective lineup for them out of necessity. They were able to claw back into the game in the first half after the Oregon 11-2 run. Now Kansas is able to stem the tide a bit with that three-point play from Lee.
Oregon is led by as many as 14. And a steal by Miles, and Ridnour digs it back out. And cross white to Joseph to a wide open Jay Anderson. Still trying to dig it out. They call the jump.
Terrific action by both clubs there.
There is some recent history, of course. Kansas beat Oregon by 18 in the NCAA Midwest Regional Final in Madison last March. That win sent the Jayhawks to the Final Four and sent Ernie Kent and his Ducks back to Eugene.
And you know that left a bad taste in their mouths. The coaching staff will tell you they thought their team was mentally fatigued after the tough run through the Pac-10 Conference, winning that championship, going through the tournament, a place they hadn't been at that level in a number of years, and just kind of ran out of gas against a very good Kansas team.
Jackson somehow knocks his way inside and caught that pass and finds two. Not blocked out. The Oregon lead is back to 9 with 9 to play in the second half. And it's Heinrich picked up by Ridnour.
Kevin, you get the sense that Kansas may not have enough firepower to fight as hard as they fought to get back in it and go over the hump. Whereas Oregon seems like they always have somebody they can go to for a bucket. Here's Jackson inside. Michael Lee, again, not conscious of where the ball was, taken advantage of by Jackson.
That gets back to that depth issue you were talking about earlier in the broadcast.
Yep. Oregon able to play 9 to 10 players, double-digit minutes. Kansas, on the other hand, not able to do that with more than 7 guys.
Let me ask about Kansas's defense, and if something has changed there, if they made a halftime adjustment, because in the first half, Oregon had 7 three-point shots. They've got just 1 here in the second half.
Well, I think they've been more conscious of tagging the shooters, especially in transition. But Oregon has been content to run the high pick and roll with Ridenour, who just sat down. And a lot of times when he penetrates, he's not going to stop behind the line. He's going to get into the paint or right near the elbow.
We're going to see the shooter. I want you to look at that one right there. Roy Williams said, I just came down to talk to Ernie. So we're going to see that last basket and see who got it.
We'll see who should be the shooter.
Right.
Heinrich is the one who was fouled. And he should be at the foul line. The officials were here to confirm that.
Six to play in the second half, and look at the difference in free throws. Kansas and Anderson with the rebound. Jayhawks down by nine at the other end. Joseph flies inside on Simeon, who just picked up his fourth personal foul.
Well, the Jayhawks late recognizing the transition opportunity. The missed foul shot. Nobody back defensively, and Oregon pushing it ahead. That's Joseph going strong to the rim to draw that foul against Simeon.
So Simeon's got four. Collison on the Kansas bench. And now off it with four. So he's just going back and forth with what he's got. But Roy Williams has done a very nice job in nursing with a not a very deep bench. Some foul problems for two significant players throughout the game.
You're exactly right, Kevin. I just don't know if they've got enough to be able to overcome this strong Oregon team that is much deeper and has a few more weapons offensively.
Williams just came to within a point here in the second half, but since that time, Oregon has kept their distance, and now up by 11, they've led by 14. Oregon has led most of the game. Langford dancing on Davis, banging his way into Anderson, outside for Michael Lee. And a rebound by Collison, and that's what they've been missing inside as he gets the rebound and the two.
Beautiful use of the left hand there after he did terrific work to get that weak side rebound.
Front court scoring there. Davis on the fly. Collison with his second rebound since coming off the bench. Miles. Nice pass inside, and Heinrich tries to contort and cut. Counted for two. And it's a 7-point game with 7:53 to play. And Ridenour comes quickly off the Oregon bench and back into the game for the Ducks.
The Jayhawks just won't go away. Every time it seems as though Oregon is on the verge of blowing them out, the Jayhawks fight back. Heinrich with a terrific shot here. Keeping his body under control, taking the contact from Joseph. Boy, alligator arm that foul shot, though.
Heinrich has 21 to lead Kansas. Luke Jackson's got 22 to lead the Oregon Ducks. Under 8 to play.
Well, just looking at Heinrich, after suffering from that cramp, you know conditioning becoming a bit of a factor for him here late.
Rolls out of bounds. And the Jayhawks will get it back. Frustrated Ernie Kent, his sixth-ranked Ducks on top of Kansas, 72-65.
Life is full of difficult choices, and some not so difficult. When you purchase an elegantly redesigned mid-size 2003 Saturn L Series, you can choose $2,500 toward your down payment. Or get 0% financing, zero down payment, and zero payments for 90 days. Unfortunately, this not-so-difficult choice ends January 2nd. Purchase a 2003 Saturn L Series and get $2,500 toward down payment or 0% APR, zero down payment, and zero monthly payment for 90 days. See participating retailer for restrictions.
I was looking for a great deal, so I talked to a good friend of mine.
Emmett was desperate.
That's when Alf told me about 1010-220.
I told him all calls up to 20 minutes are 99 cents.
I was reluctant to sign up for anything.
I told him he didn't have to sign up. Just dial 1010-220. Push the buttons, man.
Thanks to Alf, I dialed 1010-220 right then and there.
Who'd you call?
That's really none of your business.
Well,
dial 1010-220, then 1 and the number.
This is big.
Oh, good.
Tums.
Correction.
Tums Smooth Dissolve. You got Tums. Now you got this new really smooth Tums.
Well, what's it feel like?
It's like whoosh.
Yeah, like that.
Introducing new Smooth Dissolve, a velvety smooth new texture that dissolves fast, rushing relief right to where you need it.
It's like whoosh.
Yeah, like that.
New Tums Smooth Dissolve. Fast relief is a whole new texture.
They needed a miracle to win and got it. Now Arkansas meets Moussa Smith and Georgia, the SEC championship. Next on CBS. CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by 1010-220. For great long-distance rates anywhere in America and around the world, dial 1010-220. Bud Light, for the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. And by Setter, makers of the View, redesigned L Series, and the all-new Ion.
3-2 Kansas trailing 4-0 Oregon. Coming up next on CBS, the Southeast Conference Championship game presented by Dr. Pepper. And tonight, CBS, the place to be for great drama, starting with Frank T. Nelson in the district and Tom Sizemore, robbery, homicide, division. It's all here on CBS, America's most watched network, with Craig Kellogg. Craig T. Nelson. With Clark Kellogg.
I've been called worse.
I know you have. We're in the Rose Garden, which is filled to capacity, almost 19,000 people. Largest crowd ever in the state of Oregon to see a college basketball game.
They've been treated to a pretty good one. It's ebbed and flowed. Oregon has led pretty much throughout. You wonder if Heinrich's conditioning will allow him to be able to continue to carry his team as they try to fight back.
Heinrich diving down the lane and finds two. I guess that answers your question.
That may be part of the answer.
And Heinrich knocks it away from Ridenour, and Langford to Heinrich at the other end. 2-on-1 with Miles. And he can't convert. Rebound taken by Joseph, racing the other way. They've got a 3-on-3. Ridenour for two, and a rebound by Joseph. Knocked out of his hands by Miles.
Boy, that's a huge miss by Aaron Miles. After Heinrich had scored, look at him, he's down. He may be cramping up again, Kevin. Yep, he's cramping up. There's a difference between practice conditioning and game conditioning. You ramp it up about 15 to 20% more come game time. And without having been able to practice much other than yesterday, his body is starting to show the effects of that.
Now, he was in the beginning of the season, first handful of games, not shooting as much as Roy Williams wanted him to shoot. Today, 23 points and 6 rebounds, and putting in an incredibly gutty performance as Bryant Nash has shed his warm-ups and come in for Roy Williams.
Well, Roy looking to hold the fort to see if he can, in fact, get Heinrich back within the next couple of minutes. Oregon, on the other hand, will try to take advantage of his absence and extend this lead.
Oregon with Crosswhite, Jackson, Ridenour, Anderson, and Joseph, the five, as they inbound to Jackson with a nice fake to shed the defense of Lee. The tap-in try by Anderson. Jackson tears it away and somehow finds room to get it up, and it goes to Collison. Langford into Jackson, and losing it again with Crosswhite providing the defense, and they call the jump ball. Possession arrow going to Kansas.
Langford is a terrific scorer, but he's more of a catch-and-shoot guy, or 1-3 dribbles. That time he tried to pat it a little too much and almost turned it over.
Kansas with Nash, Langford, Collison, Miles, and Lee. And Heinrich trying to get himself together on the sideline and wants to come in right now.
Well, they were stretching him out. First it was his calf, then it moved up into his hamstring. Only cramps. But Heinrich, a real gamer, he doesn't want to sit out. He wants to get back out there and keep it going.
It's an offensive foul on Kansas. Collison was trying to move, as was Lee, and Lee picks up the foul. You can see the reaction of his coach. It's the third on Lee. Kansas within five. 6.5 to play. Kansas has 20 turnovers.
It's a lot to overcome, but they're still only down by five.
Jackson, guarded by Langford, finds Crosswhite and the Australian down the baseline.
What a nice box out by Lee. Good job by Collins to get the four fouls, but play aggressively without fouls.
His presence on the floor means so much underneath for Kansas as Heinrich wheels inside and picked up by Collison, who squeezes one up. And a shove and a foul, and it's on Ridnour of Oregon.
Right now, Kevin, it's basically becoming a real battle inside. You've got to be strong and aggressive. Here you see Collison, good work on the glass, unable to finish. And then Crosswhite knocks down Heinrich. Fatigue has really shown in Heinrich's last two foul shots. He missed them both. Crosswhite will sit down with four fouls. Coach Ernie Kent applauding his effort. They really like this young man, Crosswhite, a redshirt freshman from Australia. Primarily a perimeter big guy right now. Shoot it and put it on the floor. Excellent passer.
Heinrich is 7 of 10 shooting free throws. He's got 24 points, which is a game high. 22 by Luke Jackson of Oregon.
But he's missed three of his last four foul shots. You factor in a missed layup by Miles, a turnover. Kansas very well could be right on top in this game.
But they are riding a 7-0 run right now over the last 2.5 minutes. Robert Johnson back in.
This is where Ridnour looks to take over. This is where he looks to make plays.
He's got 19. He missed his last two shots, and he throws up his third consecutive miss. Simeon with the rebound. Miles picked up by Ridnour, and they go inside. There's Langford trying to scoop it up, and a foul called on Oregon. The difference in free throw shooting, Johnson just picked up his fifth, is pretty interesting. Oregon is 8 of 9, Kansas 16 of 24 from the free throw line this afternoon.
I've been covering basketball as a broadcaster for 15 years. And when you look at turnovers, free throw shooting, and rebounding, 85% of the time, the team that wins those areas is going to win your basketball game. Right now, Kansas winning his last battle and the free throw game. Turnovers may be a different story. And Oregon on top because of three-point field goals made.
Johnson leaves with 12 points and 10 rebounds. So a double-double for him. And at the free throw line is Langford, who has got 3 of 4 from the stripe this afternoon. Kansas within 3. Last time they were this close, about the 13-minute mark of the second half, down by a point, and then quickly Oregon shifted gears and went up by 11.
Well, part of the reason Kansas has been able to make this run is that they've kept Oregon out of transition. That's when they're best, when they can attack you while you're backpedaling. Everything has pretty much been a half-court game for the last few minutes.
Ridnour on top. Jackson thinking about three, maneuvers in on Lee. Kansas playing with 4 guards. And rebound by Simmons. Kansas has really been better with the one big guy in the fourth quarter.
Well, they're able to comfortably match up in their man-to-man defense against a team like Oregon that wants to play a lot on the perimeter.
Langford slithering inside. Rebound by Hellquist. And after Ridnour, Oregon has not hit a field goal in the last 4 minutes. And a timeout taken by the Ducks. Timeout taken. Ernie Kent trying to beat 13th ranked Kansas.
Sorry.
That's okay. Stop! Tim here is on his first date, and his family has some advice. With T-Mobile, families can talk all they want. Oh.
Hello?
Let her win.
Hello?
Tell her she smells nice.
Hello?
Does she come from money?
Hello?
Does she have a sister?
Wrong number.
Families talk free. Additional lines just $10. Only from T-Mobile.
Get more.
The Jayhawks creeping up on 6th-rated Oregon. 72-69 tonight on CBS. It's an all-new robbery homicide division. Man accused of murder is about to be executed, but is he really the guy? Is he really guilty? Don't miss an all-new robbery homicide division. Tonight at 10, 9 Central on CBS, America's most watched network. Collison has come back in for Kansas. No changes for Oregon. Under 5 to play. Miles on Ridenhour. And Anderson with Collison on him. Shot clock is down to 16. Jay Anderson has come up with 3 consecutive baskets. 2 in the first half and 1 right there.
Boy, a nice job of squeezing the space available in the paint.
Langford for 3. Good! Knocks it in. 2-point game approaching 4 to play.
Better strap it up, partner.
Buckle in. Ridenhour and Anderson sets a screen, and Anderson, who's hit 1-3 already, can't bury that. He's got 7 points. A rebound by Simeon. Kansas is plus 10 in rebounding today. Langford.
Too quick.
2 straight. And that ties the game at 74.
He is so quick off that first step, Kevin.
Langford has scored the last 6. Kansas has come back to tie. Closest it has been since early in the first half. Here comes Jackson, who's been very quiet, has not scored the second half, has 22 points. Shot clock is down to 10. Screen by Anderson. And Joseph, shot clock is at 2. And Ridenhour can't get it. Rebound fought for. And Jackson puts it in. A spectacular play.
Boy, he just does not stop working. He doesn't stop moving in pursuit of that ball. Look at the activity. Got inside. Simeon guilty of the foul. And that'll send him to the bench. Fighting the shot clock. 1 second on the shot clock when Luke Ridenhour takes that shot. But because the Jayhawks were in a scramble position, Jackson able to get inside and knock it down.
Simeon's got 10. He's gone. Lee takes his place. Heinrich, Collison, Langford, Lee, and Miles for Kansas. Hellquist, Anderson, Jackson, Davis, and Ridenhour for Oregon. Tap by Anderson and saved by Davis. And picked up by Kansas as Lee had Ridenhour chop him low.
They're going to call a foul, I think, on James Davis or Ridenhour. I think they called it on Davis.
With 2:55 to play.
Terrific effort again, both ways, as this loose ball comes right towards us. There's the bump by Ridenhour. Boy, that seems to be who the foul should have been committed on, called on, and it was.
So here's Portland native Michael Lee with a chance to tie it. He is now 4 of 4 from the free throw line as you take a look at his family here inside the Rose Garden today. Michael Lee has only been averaging about 10 minutes a game, but this afternoon he has had to see a lot of time because of the foul problems of Collison and Simeon.
And by virtue of how he's played, he's earned some additional playing time.
Jayhawks get it back, 2:54 and a timeout taken. Kansas coming back from 14 down to within a point with under 3 to play in Portland.
Go ahead, open it.
Oh my gosh.
The Lexus December to Remember sales event.
It's beautiful.
Mom, open it.
You'll find incredible values whether you buy or lease. December to Remember sales event.
Hey, what you got?
Missing
there?
It would definitely spoil the surprise.
Come on, let's go.
See your Lexus dealer.
I love football on TV.
shots of Gina Lee, hanging with my friends and twins. I love burritos at 4 a.m., parties that never end, dogs that love cats and twins. And I love you too. It's a love song.
The dental experts at Oral-B are on a mission to protect your teeth and gums. Their ultimate weapon, the Oral-B 3D Excel. The only toothbrush to combine a high-tech head like professionals use with a pulsating 3D motion. It cleans below the gum line, preventing and even reversing gum disease. Mission accomplished. Is it any wonder more dentists prefer brushing with the Oral-B 3D Excel? Brush like a dentist.
Our game reset. Jayhawks to within a point of number six, Oregon. We've got just under three to play. Each team with three timeouts, no fouls to give. Let's check the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. Kansas has got a 1-1 coming up and 18 free throw attempts by the Jayhawks and 10 more points from the free throw line.
That's a big number. That's why they're in the position they're in. They haven't shot the free throw that well, although they come in only shooting 65% as a team.
As the Kansas shooting 1-1, Oregon will be shooting 2. And inside they go, Collison.
Well, that's twice, Kevin, that they've missed layups with a chance that time to take a lead. A few possessions ago, Aaron Miles missed one that would have brought them to within 3. Boy, and Collison was wide open. Didn't get a clean handle, though, before he shot it.
Michael Lee, Collison to Langford.
Tough matchup here for Jackson.
And the spinning Langford. Nice defense. Hultquist and Jackson. And it goes back to the Oregon Ducks. Place at the wrong time because Jackson just tripped. Langford picks up the foul.
Langford's done a really nice job here in the second half defending Jackson. Just a little overzealous and a tad too close in his effort to deny Jackson there.
Oregon shooting 1-1.
Oregon a good free throw shooting team, although they've not been to the line much as you take a look at the free throws this half. Kansas leaving a lot of money on the table and missing half of their 12 free throw attempts.
Jackson hits. 78-75. Oregon on top of Kansas. Miles. Heinrich's got 24 points. Collison trying to dig his way inside. Throws it away. Picked up by Luke Jackson. To Luke Ridenour at the other end. Langford. And Oregon foul. Kansas is trying to dodge their first 3-3 start in 23 years.
Luke Ridenour trying to make sure that it happens that way. He just never stopped.
come in and take his place. Anderson, Luke Jackson, Luke Ridnour, Davis, and Hellquist. That's the Oregon five. Langford, Heinrich, Miles, Collison. There for the Jayhawks with Michael Lee, and Langford, 4-6 from the stripe, gets it.
If Kansas is unable to win this game, despite winning the free throw game and the rebounding game, they're going to point directly to the turnovers and a couple of missed opportunities late on some easy shot attempts.
You know, Clark, all afternoon long, Kansas is trying to dig themselves out of the hole. First 14 points, then 12 points. Right. It's been like that all afternoon.
And at some point, you just don't have enough left. And give credit to Oregon. They've bended, but they haven't broken.
Kansas has missed 7 free throws in this half alone. Jackson to Ridnour. Minute and a half to play. And Ridnour maneuvering. And that might be the dagger.
He loves that kind of opportunity.
Ridnour's got 24, a 3 by Miles, a rebound by Davis. And we're down to 61 seconds to play. Heinrich on Davis. Ridnour trying to get him out of the frame, and a foul called on Kirk Heinrich. He's cramping up again.
What an effort by Heinrich, but Luke Ridnour gets a little brush screen from Luke Jackson. Tough shot going to his left from behind the three-point line. Here you take a look. Jackson going to step out right here, and just right in there goes Jackson. Just a little hip bump. That's all the daylight Jackson Ridnour needed.
And a timeout taken with Oregon on top. Seconds to play in the second half as 13th rated Kansas is losing to number 6 Oregon 83-76 here in Portland. Oregon has led most of the game. Kansas had one-point lead, 6-5, back early in the contest. Ducks have led by 14 points, 12 points, their big lead here in the second half.
Kansas has fought very, very hard, but just hasn't been able to come up with a key play at the key time. Oregon, on the other hand, has Luke Ridnour. The big shot there, he made a big layup in transition just a couple of possessions ago. He lives for these kinds of games. Loves to step up and meet the challenge. Likes the stage. When you've got his kind of game and that kind of partner, you can make it happen.
Kansas, for the second time in the second half, had come to within a point, and Oregon has answered both times. Most recently, it was 76-75, and Oregon went on a 7-1 run.
These are both teams that have shown a lot of resilience here this afternoon. Kansas fighting hard to claw back in. Oregon fighting them off at every time.
Ridnour. He has got Oregon's last 6 points. And it's Oregon 84-76. Langford for 3. And a punch out of bounds by Oregon, so the Jayhawks will inbound. Miles with the drive and double teamed inside. And the Jayhawks are getting inbound the ball.
Kansas really doesn't have a consistent three-point shooter other than Heinrich. And he's cramping up.
Miles coming home to play in front of his Hometown this afternoon for the Jayhawks, 1 of 10. It's been a disappointing individual game for him. With a timeout.
Introducing Remington's new Microscreen TCT, built for closeness, designed for comfort, with the only triple screen system that automatically adjusts for a closer shave with less irritation. Now, just imagine how it's gonna feel.
I've been really trying, baby.
So you like it, huh?
For the ultimate in closeness and comfort, the new Remington. What a great shave feels like.
This is a man who gave up his regular pants. He wears pants that look regular, but they're not. They're Haggar Comfort Fit pants, and they have a hidden, flexible waist that's very, very comfortable. This is a man who needs flexible pants. Comfort Fit Waist, only from Haggar.
Back in Portland, Oregon, where the Kansas Jayhawks and the Oregon Ducks are battling. Welcome to the rest of our Duke, Michigan audience with Clark Kellogg, Kevin Harlan. The Southeast Conference Football Championship brought to you by Dr. Pepper is coming up next on CBS. Langford, Heinrich for three, and a rebound by Michael Lee, who digs his way up and puts in two, and a timeout taken by Kansas with the Jayhawks down by six.
You look. You stare. You hold your breath. Your pulse races. Is it the clarity? Is it the performance? Is it the sleek design? Flat panel high definition television by Samsung. It's digital temptation, and everyone's invited.
Number 22, Arkansas. Number 4, Georgia. Next from the Southeast Conference Championship game, brought to you by Dr. Pepper. Now the Jayhawks with one timeout remaining and 23.2 left on the second half clock.
Well, they'll look to force a turnover quickly, and if they don't get it, they'll need to foul right away.
Luke Jackson has played well at the other end. Andre Joseph out of bounds with the ball and a turnover.
Well, that was 5 seconds, so good enough for the Jayhawks.
Elquist will come in, and Joseph will leave. Take us inside this Kansas mindset now, down by six with about 15 seconds to play.
Quick score, it would be nice if it's a three.
They're trying for two, Elquist the rebound, and a Kansas foul at 10.5 to play. And the Jayhawks are looking right in the eyes of a 3-3 start to this season. Something they have not experienced since the 79-80 basketball campaign when the coach was Ted Owens of the Jayhawks in Lawrence.
That's been a while, but Roy Williams certainly can build on the kind of effort he got. He needs more production from Nick Collison, who got into foul trouble and did not have one of his better games.
Collison only has 7. The Chevrolet MVPs from the game today, Heinrich for Kansas and Ridenour from Oregon. Chevrolet will make a contribution to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements. Langford with a 3. Rebound Ridenour, and a big win for the Oregon Ducks. And Oregon gets a little bit of revenge after Kansas beat them last year in the NCAA Midwest Regional Final. And Kansas goes to 3-3 for the first time in 23 years. For Clark Kellogg, Kevin Harlan saying so long from the Rose Garden in Portland, Oregon, where the final score is in. Number 6, Oregon, 84. Kansas, 78. Coming up next, it's the Southeast Conference Championship game presented by Dr. Pepper as the Arkansas Razorbacks clash with the Georgia Bulldogs. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports, home of the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship.